Never in my wildest dreams did I think my eyes would see darkness donning silver wings, bringing forth such tragedy. Never in a million years would I suspect my deepest fears. Now it's all too evident, we're setting a new precedent. These are troubled times we live in. There's a lot of folks in need. They ain't got enough to pay their bills, to clothe their kids, to cure their ills. These are troubled times indeed. These are times of desperate measures. Men dictating, men of greed. They've forsaken their own people, impose their wills and call them equal. They have sold their souls to lead. These are troubled times indeed. Yeah. These are troubled times, troubled times, troubled times indeed. Oh. There are many false prophets among us. There are wolves who appear to be sheep. There are angels of death and destruction, a delight in disturbing our peace. There are innocent lives being squandered, left to die where we planted the seed. These are troubled times we live in. These are troubled times indeed. Oh, troubled times indeed. Troubled times indeed. Love is what keeps us going. Love is what tears us apart. Love is a drug that can cure us or kill us. A 40-day flood, a fortified ark, a magnificent science, and a painstaking art. Disguise that both hides and exposes the heart. These are troubled times, my friend. We've got nations to defend. Trouble in our own homeland. Things are getting out of hand. These are troubled times for sure. It's getting harder to endure. Much too easy to be lured, to have our reasoning obscured. Trouble times, trouble times, trouble times, trouble times indeed. Trouble times, trouble times, trouble times, yeah. Trouble times indeed. Trouble times indeed. Trouble times indeed. Trouble times.
Dark time for America, and a sad time for humanity. Thousands of innocent lives, each one irreplaceable and precious, were taken in a wave of evil and destruction that we still are struggling to comprehend. Many of us will know people whose lives have been taken or will be forever altered. Today, we unite in mourning their deaths, and we pray for their families and the injured to find the strength to pick up the pieces of their shattered lives and carry on. Gone too is the sense of invincibility in which we took our personal safety and national security pretty much for granted. Now, we must learn the hard way that we can take nothing for granted, that life and everything we truly hold dear in life are gifts to nourish and cherish, for they can all vanish the next instant. Today, we are experiencing a range of emotions all strained to maximum pitch. Evil again has been loosed upon the world, this time in our own backyard that we thought was secure. We are filled with shock, anger, despair, anxiety, confusion, and grief, a brew of understandable reactions that challenges our spiritual beliefs and civic values. However, I have seen members of this community and Americans everywhere affirm those beliefs and values by unleashing the greatest weapon against evil, our humanity. I see emergency personnel risk their lives to rescue fellow citizens by the thousands. I see our entire community standing together as one family, each of us reaching out to help a friend or stranger in pain or need. Through each act or gesture of our humanity, we take one step toward resisting evil and healing the wounds that evil has inflicted on our country and world. The course of America's history has changed forever. The world we knew before the awful events of September 11th, 2001 is gone. But we have the power to transmute the most horrific national catastrophe into a resolve for moral action that establishes the primacy of goodness in the world. We can and we will emerge from this ordeal, sadder to be sure, but richer in compassion and wisdom, and more determined to affirm the best of our common humanity. We come together to mourn. We stand together to heal. We leave together a community.